The dark web is under attack. A number of major markets are being flooded with denial of service attacks. DDoS attacks can often originate from unsecured Internet of Things devices. For Tech Republic and ZDNet in New York, I'm Dan Patterson with Anthony Greco. He is the Trust Strategy Officer at Cisco. Anthony, we know that DDoS attacks can originate from IoT devices, but they're not the only type of cyber attack that can come from IoT, and a number of IoT flaws can leave your company vulnerable to attacks. So first, thanks a lot for your time. It's always great learning from you. Beyond simple DDoSing, what are some of the vulnerabilities that IoT devices that don't have patched firmware can expose your company to?
Yeah, Dan, it's great to talk to you again. When we think about IoT, especially in the context of businesses and enterprises, there's a couple of really important things to think about. First and foremost, every business needs to understand that they have IoT devices deployed in their enterprise and really get to grips with that. Whether it's a connected TV that they brought into their break room or a connected HVAC system. And increasingly, many businesses are actually building the IoT types of capabilities into the products that they're delivering to the market. And so first and foremost, the reality becomes every business that we're dealing with today is touching on or using IoT in some way, shape, or form fundamentally. And when we think about that and we think about the risks that come with that, we really tend to begin to think about them more to the positive when you think about cybersecurity, which is it's clear that there's a business benefit when it comes to IoT devices and the capabilities that they bring. But ultimately, businesses have got to start to think about them as when I take care of cybersecurity proactively in these environments, it's going to continue to allow me to build the capabilities of that I and the benefits that I get from IoT devices into my products and services and frankly make me more profitable, agile as a business. So when we look at the overall approach to think about IoT, it's really easy to think about them on the risk side, but we also think about proactively dealing with cybersecurity in that space is really fundamental to growth of the businesses that we're dealing with. So if you look at the risks that come from compromised IoT devices, you touched on DDoS. They oftentimes become a part of an army of DDoS bots out there attacking others. We've seen other instances where they become a vector to move throughout an enterprise laterally within the enterprise itself. And obviously, depending on what the thing itself is, there's a number of situations where you could have disruption of service that could result from compromised IoT devices. Ultimately, we think that thinking about cybersecurity proactively in the context of those risks in the IoT space is really critical. And there's some simple things that we should be thinking about doing in that space that we would like to start to encourage enterprises to begin to think about. One that's really critical for us is segmentation. Thinking about how you bring barriers, virtual barriers between things that are connected to other assets within your enterprise is a really critical thing that most enterprises are only beginning to think about. So making sure that those things are segmented becomes a fundamental idea of helping limit damage if there is a compromise and helping limit exposure when that happens. When you segment them too, the other thing that you get from that is you get a point of visibility. Now you get to see what's happening in that thing space where you've connected those devices to your network. And that gives you an opportunity to really operationalize security in that space. Look for anomalies, create capabilities to respond to incidents that might happen. So those two fundamental things are really things that most enterprises need to be doing today. And we find many are beginning down that path, but many are also struggling with where to start in the IoT security space overall.
Are there ways... just like the move to the cloud and the move to mobile, particularly with bring your own devices, there are often retraining initiatives inside companies to get their employees to think about not just the benefits and efficiencies that devices can bring, but also the risks. Are there ways to get employees to think about the cyber risk of network devices in the same way that we did with mobile devices?
It's a great observation, and given this National Cybersecurity Awareness Month on the tail end of it, it's an important observation to think about how do you raise the awareness within your employee base. The first thought process that has to go through the experts' minds that live with inside these enterprises is the number one goal has got to be to get everybody inside of the enterprises aware of their role from a cybersecurity perspective. I've been in the cybersecurity space for over 15 years, and the problem for us, frankly, has been it's been an expert-only conversation. And that mindset shift has really got to happen within experts inside of the industry to bring a broader set of people into the conversation. So if you're building a product that has a connective capability that you're delivering to the market, now you have a whole new line of people, even outside of the IT organization, that need to start to think about cybersecurity. If you look at the things that Cisco's doing in this space, we've done a lot to educate our employees to think about cybersecurity, no matter what the job role is. We have a ninja training program that trains all of our employees on basic cybersecurity. And then depending on your job role, there's very specific things that give you more specific training. In addition to that, we have a whole awareness campaign going on across our 170 different countries that are happening right now in October in order to build an understanding of what everyone's responsibility is. Ultimately, the key, though, is to make sure that the folks that are your cybersecurity experts, the people that are accountable for the cybersecurity risk for the business, aren't the only ones thinking about cybersecurity. And first and foremost, that takes them to shift their mindset to be teachers, not just owners of the expertise.
It's great advice. And I kind of set that up intentionally to juxtapose with what you said a moment ago about segmentation of devices within the enterprise. Because often as humans and as employees, we are encouraged to think about our company laterally, particularly with that great advice about cybersecurity. How do we do both of those things? We feel mounting pressure on both ends. One, to be more connected with other parts of our company and to have greater awareness into our company, but also to protect ourselves and make sure that we segment not just data and operations, but the cyber risk. How do we do both of those things at the same time?
Well, so I think there's some real basic realities which say that there is going to be business drivers that are going to push your business down this path of digitization and using technology. We've done some surveys. 80% of the 1,000 CXOs that we surveyed across the globe said that they were currently engaged in a fundamental business transformational program that was technology based. They were digitizing their business, and it was going to transform their business. Now, the challenge with that is 40% of them have had to stop one of those key initiatives because of a cybersecurity concern. And so what you see is there's a demand to drive down that path of connectivity, collaboration, bringing the technology together, getting data from your products as they're deployed. And then this notion of segmentation isn't necessarily orthogonal to it. It's very directly related to it, because as you think about creating and thinking about cybersecurity proactively, techniques like segmentation bring an ability to manage the cybersecurity risk in a proactive way. Not the only way that you do it. And indeed, we talked about education, we talked about segmentation, we talked about visibility, we talked about future capabilities that would be built in. But ultimately, the business is going to have to be agile and digitized. That will happen. And so the only option from my perspective is to really think proactively about how to deploy things like segmentation that enable the business in order to drive the outcomes that are being looked for from within the enterprise.
That's the house of digital transformation that is occurring in large part by Internet of Things. So that's really at the nutshell of changing not just how a company approaches cybersecurity, but why and the fiber of cybersecurity being woven into the company. Anthony Greco is the Trust Strategy Officer at Cisco. Anthony, I wonder if you could leave us with, you always come with very practical advice. So as my company or any company leans into 2018, IoT is tied into every company's initiatives. Where and how do I make good decisions about applying IoT as a decision maker, and then how do I have conversations about IoT security with my team to make sure I can accomplish this digital transformation and keep my company secure.
Yeah, Dan, the simple statement that I give to everyone is early and often, thinking about cybersecurity early in those digitization activities, from the time that you have the idea of how you're going to use that technology to transform your business, all the way through the design, the implementation, and ultimately the fielding, and even out to the end of life of your product or services or your enterprise solution that you're deploying, you've got to think about cybersecurity throughout that. So ultimately, when we think about it, it must be thought about in every phase of that transition. And the earlier you do it, the more effective it's going to be, the more simple it's going to be, and the more overall risk you're going to mitigate throughout the life cycle, making your company and the project that you're a part of more agile.